I've been waiting for this trailer. This trailer is a really big deal. I mean, if Mel Gibson's gonna make a comeback, this is where it's going to start. If Andrew Garfield is gonna make a comeback, this is where it's going to start. They both, though, have aces up their sleeves. Andrew Garfield has this Martin Scorsese picture in the wings, and then Mel Gibson could always play his Passion of the Christ 2 card. However, if this film isn't able to get awards consideration, he might not be able to get financing for Passion of the Christ 2, because clearly Hollywood just isn't going to get over his previous transgressions, which were pretty bad, particularly for the Hollywood set. So let's see if the power of his filmmaking, which is mighty powerful, by the way, I mean, we're talking Braveheart, Apocalypto, if that talent can overcome his prejudices. Let's see. It's a tall order. It's a tall order. But he has been known to be that good. Okay, let's take a look at Hacksaw Ridge. This is also, by the way, at the DNC last night. Leon Panetta was speaking at the Democratic National Convention, and some Bernie Sanders supporters in particular were, you know, chanting against his speech, even though he was, you know, a friendly speaker, you know, chanting no more war. And this is a very sophisticated look at the complexities of war and who gets involved and what they believe in. And this is also, I think, a very appropriate time for this film. So let's see. Let's see. There's a lot going on here.
What the hell is your delay, Captain?
We're waiting, sir.
Waiting for what?
Private Doss.
Who the hell is Private Doss?
I always dreamed about being a doctor, but didn't get much school. I can't stay here while all them go fight for me.
What, you figure this war is just going to fit in with your ideas?
While everybody else is taking life, I'm gonna be saving it. And that's gonna be my way to serve.
This is a personal gift from the United States government designed to bring death to the enemy.
Well, I'm sorry, Sergeant. I can't touch a gun.
You don't kill.
No, sir.
You know, quite a bit of killing does occur in war.
Private Doss does not believe in violence. Do not look to him to save you on the battlefield.
I don't think this is a question of religion.
I think this is cowardice.
I fell in love with you because you weren't like anyone else. Saying you could go to prison.
I don't know how I'm gonna live with myself if I don't stay true to what I believe. With the world so set on tearing itself apart, doesn't seem like such a bad thing to me to want to put a little bit of it back together.
It's a great
Private
accent,
Doss, you are free to run into the hellfire of battle without a single weapon to protect yourself.
See if they actually say Mel Gibson's name.
I'm gonna get you home.
There's something you gotta see.
Who did this?
That's the card.
We have to go back up tomorrow. And they're not gonna go up there without you. Help me.
Let me get one more.
They did not say Mel Gibson. Oh, it made me all teary-eyed. That was so beautiful. As many of you know, I do have some problems with what Mel Gibson said. Just in general, but also personally, because a lot of his comments were very misogynistic. But I do still have a lot of respect for him as a filmmaker. And this looks masterfully crafted, and out of respect for not only Mel Gibson, but really, it's hard to even say that, but I have to say that largely out of respect for what this man did, that Andrew Garfield is portraying, I would definitely see this movie. And I think that I think the combination of the true story and what looks like a fabulous performance from Andrew Garfield, who I always liked as Spider-Man, and I know many of you did as well. I think a lot of other things tripped him up, but it certainly wasn't Andrew Garfield in that role. I would go and see this movie for sure, and I would think that Hollywood perhaps would consider it for awards, because it's so strong. But you can see nobody wants to work with Mel Gibson. Andrew Garfield needs this role, which is why he took it. He's the biggest star in the movie. Mel Gibson couldn't draft any other award-friendly actors into this film. And you can see that in the casting, which makes it a little bit weak. They won't say his name in the trailer. Even the studio, Summit Lionsgate, is not an awards-friendly studio. You know, usually before Mel Gibson did what he did, this would have gone to a much bigger player who would have been able to do a really good job launching it. So this hero, this real hero, this real-life hero, not only did he have to prove himself on the battlefield, but he's marching into award season without a single Oscar weapon. And he's going to have to prove himself all over again. But I think he can do it. It's very powerful. I'm very impressed. I hope that this gets the support it deserves. So I'm curious, what do you think? Do you think that this can redeem Mel Gibson's career? Or do you think he won't get in the way of it? What do you think of Andrew Garfield's performance? And what do you think of this film's awards chances? Write your thoughts down below. Thank you so much for watching with me. And you can check out some more episodes right now.